Myron Roker is the oldest living resident of Claytonia.
And he said, hey, look, Mom, no hands.
And throughout his life, Myron has always been years ahead of his time.
You were the modern day, DirecTV.
And speaking of modern, he's talking into a mic and that's going to my ears. And I hear you just fine. Well, there used to be two grocery stores here, John Ricker's and Ben Wagner. But Omar Bread came in and started going house to house selling pastries and bread. So Ben Wagner didn't want to be outdone. So Sam Walker was working for him at that time. And so he had Sam build a trailer that hooked up to my bicycle. And I got the job of going door to door with that. And oh, it was hot. And I don't know how them pastries, how frosty. But that didn't last. Very long. It was Bill Heller, I'm pretty sure it was him. He made a trucking place out of it. We had airmail here, but it was only one time. I wrote a letter to Keith Iwan, and he wrote one to me, but I'm sure it never went on the plane. At least I still got that letter from Keith Iwan. The Beatrice Daly son used to fly and drop the papers up on the school ground. And I used to carry them. I built a radio that was on my bicycle. I had a white cat. For some reason, she liked to sit on my shoulder. And I delivered the papers and listened to the radio station, and the cat sat on my shoulder and went everywhere I did. Where the post office is, Leidick owned that, and he had a drugstore there, and he had a soda fountain. And that was during the Depression. Well, I guess I was born 30 years ahead of my time. TV came out in 1948, and the first TV I seen was in Dallas, Texas. And they were playing baseball, and they were televising that. Well, when I got discharged from the service, I could have went back to work on the railroad here in Claytonia, but I didn't see a future in that. So I went to Milford, Nebraska. At that time it was called the trade school. I graduated from there in July of 1947. Before I got out of school, 6 months before I got out of school, I bought a half interest in a radio repair shop in Seward, Nebraska. George Gertis, he bought into the hardware store here at Claytonia. He tried to talk me into moving down here and have radio and TV for sale. We moved here in January 50, and this town was really busy at that time. Two hardware stores, and two grocery stores, two restaurants. The old bank building come up for sale, and so I wanted to buy that. And of course, I didn't have no money. I went to the bank to see about a GI loan and they were hesitant in borrowing me the money. So I told my folks about it, and my folks and my aunt, they said that they could come up with the money for it. Well, when the bank found that out, then they were agreeable to loan me the money. So I took a GI loan out on that. But the fellow by the name of Boltman at Falls City, Nebraska, he was a farmer, but he invented the umbrella for the Ford tractor, and that's where he made his money. And he moved his factory into Falls City, and then he had been east, like in Pennsylvania, that, and he found out about cable TV, and that's how I found out about it. And so he used to make his own fittings out of brass to hook the houses on. And his system was underground, and I thought, why can't I do that in Claytonia? So I went in on borrowed money, and we buried the cable. And that would have been probably in 1952, if I remember right. Lee Heller had to, it was all his John Deere tractor could do to plow that cable in. He started over there where Harvey and Verlinda run the tavern. And he had his men, I told him, you have to protect my cable because it runs over there. And he had them dig around that. Well, then up at the a block north, he had them go right through it. And I went after him, and he says, well, it's cheaper for me to pay the repair than it is to pay the men. A long story short, I did have about $600 insurance on the cable. And I went down to Beatrice to the insurance company, and they said, well, you take photographs of every break. And come to find out, lo and behold, the contractor went bankrupt.